senior commissioned officer from Indian Army who served Indian Army for 30 years and now he is being asked for any army man who has served this country honorably that after 30 years of service he is being asked by the BJP Assam government to prove his nationality. And please remember that the foreigners tribunal in last 2 years they have issued 40,000 is being taken to demean people by asking them to show their nationality citizenship. And the biggest example which has come to the public notice is of Azmal Haq, who after serving 30 years in an Indian army is now being asked to prove citizenship. I hope that common sense will prevail on the BJP Assam government and they will stop this kind of activity, which is nothing but targeting Indian citizens who are living peacefully in Assam.
Now what we are also taking into the picture is the state, and we've been seeing some unfortunate incidents in Gorakhpur and also the Varanasi thing. So there's a lot of comments that we're seeing that he's handling his chief minister duty as a part-time. He also plans to involve in a lot of priest duties on Diwali as well. So what do you have to say about that?
See, first thing is that the chief minister of Uttar Pradesh going and staying for nearly 5 days with all the security and all the paraphernalia which comes with a chief minister going and leaving his office in Lucknow and staying in a particular place, that too to perform as a Mahant. That in itself is a violation of the recent Supreme Court order, wherein the Supreme Court said that public money cannot be used for religious purposes. That is a recent order. So the chief minister going and staying there for 5 days and all the arrangements that are being made for his stay, whose money is being used? It is the public exchequer which is being burdened with the chief minister's stay of 5 days to perform his duties as a Mahant. I have no issues whatsoever with anyone performing his religious functions or duties, because religion is part and parcel of our life. But if you are holding a constitutional post of a chief minister and staying over there for 5 days, it is an additional burden on the public exchequer, especially in the light of what happened in government hospital UP, wherein hundreds of children died because of lack of oxygen. And 2 days ago, from the place where the chief minister is going to stay for 5 days, there is a hospital called Baba Raghav Das Medical College. If media reports are true, 44 children have died in 2 days. Will the chief minister go and visit that hospital? More than 10 incidents of communal clashes have taken place during the Mohram procession. Power has become irregular. So I feel that Yogi Adityanath as Mahant is overshadowing Adityanath as the Chief Minister of UP, which is, you know, there's a thin line between a constitutional duty and public beliefs. Unfortunately, the present Chief Minister of UP has blurred that line, and I would say that that in the interest of propriety and in the interest of general public, to sustain purity of public life, the chief minister in future should not engage himself in any such activities which leads to direct conflict between his constitutional duties. So what we have seen is that he has failed as an administrator so far, and Yogi Adityanath as a Mahant is overshadowing, unfortunately, Yogi as the chief minister, which is a constitutional post.